Good morning.
Good morning.
We escaped the bullet last night and all the snow went inside. On this day, you know, we're here to worship the Lord, but you know, the Lord had a sense of humor. So don't take offense when I tell the story. Because I can picture my wife and I a few years down the road here. There's this man and woman. They're up in their years. And the wife was saying, you know, you can't remember nothing. I'm taking you to the doctor. So she took him to the doctor. She explained to the doctor what was going on. He can't remember nothing. So the doctor said, okay. So he runs him through a series of tests. And he comes back and he says, I'm sorry, he said, I can't find nothing wrong. He said, it's just part of growing up in your years. He says, the only thing I can tell you, you have to write everything down. If you ask him to do something, ask him to write it down. So that evening, they were sitting in front of the TV like most Americans do. And the husband said, you know, he said, I'm kind of hungry. I'm going to go to the kitchen and get something to eat. He says, do you want something? She goes, yes. She said, I want a bowl of vanilla ice cream. She said, okay. So he gets up and she goes, don't you think you should write that down? No, I can remember a bowl of vanilla ice cream. She goes, yeah, but I want some strawberries on it. Okay. A bowl of vanilla ice cream with strawberries. Well, don't you think you should write that down? Honey, I can remember a bowl of vanilla ice cream with strawberries. Yeah, but I want some more cream on it. Okay. She goes, don't you think you should write that down? He said, honey, I can remember vanilla ice cream, strawberries, and whipped cream. So off to the kitchen he goes, and he's out there for quite a while. Pretty soon he comes back in carrying a tray, bacon and eggs. She said, I told you you should have written it down. She said, where's my toast? Okay, some of the announcements there, you can see David W. and Matthew Green have some findings. Okay. And on January 23rd, from 5:30 to 8:30, security for houses and worship workshop. Pre-registration is required. And the presenter is Bob Winters. He's from the Protective Security Advisor of Pittsburgh, U.S. Department of Homeland Security. Youth Prayer Ministry, please take the opportunity to place your prayer request in the weekend room. And our youth is selling calendars. See one of the youth or see Amy Smith. Other announcements, Bible study, January 14th, New Bethlehem United Methodist Church. And January 16th, Oak Ridge Bible study, and they're all 7 p.m. The co-op calendar, January 15th, 1-4, the RVCA food pantry. The 17th, 7 a.m., men's breakfast. And 7 p.m., co-op SPRC meeting. Bethlehem United Methodist Church. January 22nd, 6 p.m., the ladies' night out. More information later. And the 24th, 7 p.m., prayer vigil. The 14th, this week's opportunities. The 14th, 7 p.m., the trustee meeting. The 16th, at 6:15, the Christian Ed meeting, followed by choir and anvil. Upcoming events in the church. Now, this has been changed. It was January 22nd. It is now January 24th at 6 p.m. That's the mission meeting. January 27th at 5 p.m. junior and youth. Are there any other announcements?
There is a worship committee meeting right after service. It should have been in the announcements, but it somehow missed. There will be a worship committee meeting right after service.
other announcements? Yes.
I need two people to make 2 dozen cupcakes for Thursday night.
Got any volunteers for 2 dozen cupcakes for Thursday night?
Yes.
Okay.
That's for the dollar dinner.
We are having the dollar dinner this coming Thursday.
This coming Thursday, yes. Dollar dinner. And that's what the cupcakes are for.
Yes.
Dollar dinner Thursday. That starts at
4 o'clock.
They usually put on some pretty good meals.
What do they have?
What do we have?
Soup and sandwich.
Soup and sandwiches for Thursday. Okay. No other announcements? Will you take your little black handbook, page 2074?
honestly forgot what I was going to do when I came up here. As our ushers come forward, let us take this opportunity to prepare our hearts and our minds for the beginning of our time.
Thank you.
Now we come to the time when we can lift up our joys and our concerns. First of all, do we have a report from the youth?
The youth are thankful for our spa day event yesterday, our parents, hardworking people, and heat.
Thank you. I have a list here from the Sunday school class, lifting up prayers for our government, our country, our homeless, Johnny and Cheryl Kellerman, Paula Wheeler, Barb Lovell, Barb and Love Lum Adams, Amy Hodge, Emily Taddeo, our pastors, the co-op, the drug problems, Jody Schick, Jack Sloggenhop, and Drew. And before we get started, was I seeing things? Was Amy Watson here?
Yes, she was.
Where was she at? Did she leave? Okay. Oh, well,
part of your plan.
Well, yeah, room is part of my plan. We'll do the first step here. I have a joy and a prayer request, but the joy we'll talk about first. Being blessed with serving three churches regularly at the time of Christmas and in the fall during Pastor Appreciation, I get overwhelmed with love and compassion and hospitality from so many people in our churches. My intentions were to send out thank you cards, and I don't think that's going to happen, because this is my prayer. Right now, I am bogged down with schoolwork to the point I don't know whether I'm coming or going, and it's hard to find time to get everything fitted into a day, so pray for me. I know God will get me through it. I'm getting to the point, I'm in the upper level classes now, and the workload is just getting more and more with that, right now I feel overwhelmed. So I decided I'm going to publicly thank all of you and praise God for all of you who sent cards, gifts, various gifts of food and even monetary gifts. Me and my family have been blessed by all of you. And I just want to say thank you. And it is such a blessing to be serving you folks. So thank you. And I praise God for every one of you. I wanted to acknowledge Amy for our Christmas Eve service. That was my other. A lot of you don't know that Amy headed up that skit, and she coordinated, she wrote the whole skit up and got everything coordinated, and they practiced. They only practiced two Sundays before that. And I wanted to acknowledge her for that, and I was so happy when I saw her when I come in, and then I thought, was I seeing things? Or, anyway. What's that? I just couldn't believe, she's here and then she wasn't. So I'll catch you another time. That's the downside of coming in when I do. Because I'm not here for announcements or anything like that. So I don't like this, but it is what it is, and I have to deal with it. So moving on, any joys for today?
You did a wonderful job yesterday.
Thank you, yes. Let's get on the team. Amy.
I'd just like to expand on that. Thank you to everyone who made that big donation of food or monetary, came and received some services. We just really appreciate everybody's participation anyway.
Thank you.
Thank you to Ken and Sandy for their hospitality last night. It was a wonderful evening. We had a wonderful evening.
My adult children call him Grumpy Guy. He spearheaded a really successful surprise 80th birthday party for my mother last night, so she was pretty surprised.
Didn't know you had it in you. Any others? Praise God.
But the new boiler's in and working, so.
Yeah. And it feels good.
We should also thank Galen because he worked alongside the guy who does that kind of stuff. And so he gave a lot of his time, and so we owe him a debt to him.
Yes. Thank you, Galen. Any others?
For 1 year now, we've been working on our basement. Jane Murphy shall tell you that we've been fixing our basement. There's something over there. Anyway, we had some bookshelves, and I was asking anybody and everybody in the Lord to bring something. Well, we had somebody went to Bible study, and the Lord dropped somebody right in my lap to take care of his bookcase. Amy Clark, she told me. So now the Lord is good. At least a loss for the bookshelf.
Yeah.
I just wanted to pass on behalf of Aaron. We all know how he's kind of the inventor and entrepreneur. He is so excited. He has a job through Penn State where he's working with an innovation company.
Oh, wow.
Part time for now, but we'll see where it goes. I'm very excited about that. Good for him.
We do that kid in my song.
Any others? How about prayer with us?
DJ?
Unspoken.
Any other unspoken requests? Traveling mercies. There's probably still a lot of people traveling back, heading home for Christmas break and so forth.
Joanne Mooney.
Joanne?
Joanne Mooney. She's having surgery Tuesday.
Pray for Joanne Mooney. Any other? Steve Root. Any other birthdays coming up? Anybody wants to admit?
Betty had a birthday.
Betty? Let's sing happy birthday. If not, let's go to prayer.